What's going on, everyone? Rising World here on the Playpen today. Game's still fairly new. It's been out for a little while. These guys have been working pretty hard on it. Alpha 0.6 right now. So they've been doing updates on it almost what seems like to be every month. And every time they come out, there's fixes and things that they incorporate. Like just recently, they incorporated the trading system for the multiplayer. We're not going to be doing multiplayer today. We're doing some single player, so I'm going to create a new world here. Right off the bat, this is all the normal settings here, so you have all the animals and jaguar. Ooh, I haven't seen that yet. Fox, elephant, rabbit, rhinoceros, sheep, tigers. I'm going to keep all that in there. Vegetation, caves, ores, world type is normal. You have a couple different ones to choose from as well. You've got super flat and surreal. Now, unless you're a really big adventure guy and you want hardcore, surreal is going to be the way you're going to want to go. Just for the short time I was on it, I found no vegetation, no green anywhere. It's just peaks of mountains. That's it. Pillars of mountains, if you will, actually. So if you like being in a cave and nowhere else but a cave, that might be the world for you. But today we're going to be doing survival. So let me go ahead and edit that, and let me just roll the dice here, close my eyes, and boom. Alright, that's the seed we're going to use. Create the game. Now this is basically an adult Minecraft, to be quite honest. I mean, look at how well this looks. It looks awesome. And I'm sitting up in the air for some reason. There we go. You start off with a couple basic tools. You got an axe and a pickaxe. That's going to be it. Inventory is all empty. Obviously, you can have armor and equipment and so on. And crafting, you can start off with a couple basic items. Build a shelter and a fireplace. Stick and lumber. Torch and torch mount. You cannot place torches on the ground. You have to use a torch mount. So if you're going to put a torch down on a wall or on the ground, you got to build one of those. And then you're going to have to also make a workbench. And the workbench really opens up on what you can do here. Okay. I want to get off this mountain. I'm not in the mood to be building on a... Oh, I mean, although this... Not in the mood to be building on a mountain. So I'm going to head on down to the flatland. One thing also to keep in mind is while you're running around, watch out for caves. There are caves everywhere around here. And sometimes they're not always outlined. Oh, crap. That's a bear. I never saw him, and that's a bear. That's a bear. Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. The top of the hill. He's still behind me? No, he's not. There he is. He must have gotten stuck in a tree. And damn it, that's where I wanted to go, was over there. Let's see. Let me go out this way, go around him. Bears and tigers, and I would imagine jaguars will attack you. They don't need provocation. Other animals, everything else is passive. But if provoked, there are some animals that will attack you. Elephants and rams, for example, will attack you if you provoke them. So if you go up and smack them, they're going to hit back. And they hit back kind of hard. I'm surprised I didn't take any damage on that either. Okay. You don't have to kill a sheep. Just walk up to it. Hit F, and I don't remember if that's the normal key binding for it or not. I changed it to F. I think it was something else originally. I imagine moose would be along the same way, where if you hit them, they will hit back, so... Now, I personally have not really tested all that much, so I don't know if the different woods will give you different lumber, like, you know, Minecraft. I know I've played around with the brick, and although I just had regular stone, it allowed me to basically make any kind of stone item I wanted to make, regardless of the color. Not sure if that's going to change in the future. I wouldn't rule it out. One other thing you are not going to find, so don't even bother searching for it, is water. You will not find water on this map, or any map for that matter. So, how do you keep yourself hydrated, you might ask? Well, that's pretty simple to do. Eat some tomatoes. Watermelon is another item that you can eat, and that will rehydrate. Trying to remember what else there was. I think there was one other item that will rehydrate you. And I am drawing a blank on that right now. Apples are a good beginner's food source as well, but you can kill the animals like pigs, and pigs give you bacon, cows and things like that. And then you can put them on the grill and or the campfire, smoker, whichever you prefer, and you can go ahead and cook them up, and that will of course fill you up more than just apples will. I do see a winter biome on the horizon there. I don't feel like going in there. You are a loud one, aren't you? Let's see. Looking for a good place. Looking for a good place. What's on the top of this hill here? I don't mind being on top of a hill as long as it's still fairly flat on the top. No, this one here isn't that bad. I'm picky about where I build, and I honestly hate it. But oh, almost walked right off the edge there. I'll search for hours, and no, I don't like that one. No, I like this one. Oh, but let's see if there's something better. I'm indecisive when it comes to it, and I honestly hate it. And then I'll just say screw it. You're setting up here, and that's that. I'm never happy. So, finding that perfect spot can be difficult. I don't have to take this stump here, but I don't like leaving them behind, so. Besides, it is one extra piece of wood, so why not just take the extra 5 seconds or so and just take it out, get that extra piece of lumber, and what's in my way? You're in my way? See, I might try to be. That's one thing I'm kind of annoyed with is the terrain gen here, and you got stuff that's just floating. I'm sure eventually they will fix that. But yeah, it is a little annoying. You know what? This looks like a decent spot. The other thing you are not going to find here is any AI characters. You're not going to find villages or anything like that. Ancient temples or none of that stuff is in this game. So it's basically a brand new world. You're starting out in it. Whoa, hello. And you're the only one here. You're all alone. And it won't be long until you go crazy. Okay, so we got inside the forest. This is where I was wanting to go. Oh, another bear. There are limitations to weapons. There's only a handful here. Three of them: Sword, Battle Axe, and Morning Star. I would like to see ranged weapons. I'm a little surprised there are no ranged weapons, but you know, I imagine at some point in time they will be added in, but it would have been nice to at least have a bow and arrow option. Let's see what I tell you. Oh, this is a nice spot. That's a nice spot. And what do I do? I run away from it. Oh, hello, another bear. And I don't think I'm seeing so many bears because I'm in the forest. I've seen bears all over the place, so they're not limited to just the forest. We are getting next to a mountain. One other downside, and it's something that everyone should keep in mind if you're playing this game, is that watermelon and pumpkins do not stack. I'd like to find a lemon tree, but I don't think I'm going to find one. Another issue is there is no map, so you guys are going to have to kind of keep track of where you're at, and you're not going to really be able to do that until you make a compass. The compass will have a needle that points to your spawn, which would be your bed, I assume, at all times. So that is one way to find your way home. If you really travel far out, you just look at your compass and it'll point you in the direction you need to go. One other option is if you hit F3. Now, if you look up there towards the right-hand side of that top line, you see global 169, 89, 1, or 1408, just like Minecraft. So you got your X and Y and your Z, so, or however, which way that's supposed to go. But, you know, if you guys play Minecraft, you get the point. You know what that's about. So, as you can see, I'm coming down off the hill now. I'm back to level 71, 72, so. And actually, I'm in a decent area. Also, if you hit F3 again, you're going to see the graph there, memory, CPU, and FPS. Normally, I run around 200. I've seen it bounce as low as 130, though. It all depends on what's being loaded into the map. See, there's that winter biome again over here. So I'm going to stay over here. I'm going to go back close to the forest. Nighttime is coming, that sun's going down. So the first day is almost over. How many apples? Okay, I got apples stacked to 32. I know stone goes to 64. Everything has its own little limit on how high it goes. Nope, wrong button. There we go. Thank you. Grab some more apples while I'm out here. Lemon trees are kind of few and far between, so I usually cut them down whenever I can so I can get a sapling and bring them back to where I'm going to be. I've never made anything out of a lemon tree yet, but I would imagine you can still eat the lemons and that'll act as, that'll rehydrate you. Out rid of trees. I think I'll stay right around in this area here. Hey, you know what? Right between these two hills. That might work. Yep. Right here between these two hills looks like a nice little spot. That is a decent sound too. I mean, they've done very well here with the textures, with how everything looks. Where'd that one go? There it is. as well as a lot of the sounds. The sounds are pretty spot on as well. So myself and some of the other guys on the Evil Gaming Network, we're really starting to enjoy this, and we're actually thinking about setting up a server for it once they work out some of the bugs. There are some bugs with multiplayer that we have found in our testing. Issues with the forge, where you know you go to take items out and they don't go out, even though I can see that they're gone. They're still there. What was another issue? I'm trying to remember here. Oh, issues with things that you know we can no longer have access to. We have to log out and log back in for. So there are a couple of issues that have to be worked out, have to be figured out. And, you know, I trust the developers here. They'll get it all figured out and taken care of. And before we know it, we're going to have a very viable adult version of Minecraft that people are really going to enjoy. I mean, there's already mods being worked on, texture packs being worked on, so the interest is there for this game. And it's also pretty relaxing, too, as long as you can stay away from bears and tigers. It's a fairly simple builder's game. There we go. I think that was a rabbit. And judging from some of the photos I've seen of projects people have done on this game on Steam, you know, you can pretty much mimic real life here pretty well when it comes to buildings and items. Alright. Let's see, I'll probably stay right around here, go back by the trees maybe a little bit. So let's get going on some stuff here. Crafting. I'm not going to worry about a shelter. Crafting stations, make a workbench, but I got to have lumber first. So resources, lumber. And there's no time limit on these. You don't have to wait for anything. They get produced right away. There we go. And you know what? While I'm doing all this, F to get back into this. I need some sticks. I'm going to make some torches and some holders. Unlike Minecraft, you cannot just place torches down. You have to make these torch mounts, and then you just kind of stick those in the ground wherever you're at. So if you're tunneling down, stick them up on the wall or on the ground. Same thing here, you just put them on the ground, and now you can have your torches for everything. And let's see, get those up there. Cow does not sound like he's having fun. Now when you place these in this tall grass here, just try to remember, try not to move your mouse. Otherwise, good luck, see, yeah, there we go. Good luck finding it in this tall grass. Okay, so we got some light going on here. So I have here, I think I have enough lumber, I can start doing something. So we have lots of different things here. Wooden signs, metal signs, ladders, great if you're going to go climbing down into a cave. Crafting stations, multiple different ones, a block bench to make all the stone bricks and things like that, wood blocks. Anvil, smelting furnace, that's what I need to get stone for. I was told Yeah, it looks like the posters are free. And the nice thing about these posters is you can import your own photos and you can use those on the photo itself. So, very cool little personal touch that people can put on their homes. Smoker grill, cooking grill. Let's see, here's the three weapons: Morningstar, Battle Axe, which I plan on making because that just looks cool as hell, and a sword. There's your clock and then a compass, which is a nice tool to have. And then these are your different tools: your sickle, rolling pin. You got a scythe for cutting the grass. Rake also does the same thing. It'll smooth out the terrain as well. Sledgehammer, and then a garden hoe. Multiple different lights, and this is a nice little touch here, like the wall mount one. That's nice. The little tiki lamp here for the garden. So you have lots of different options here to kind of really make things look nice. And then this with that workbench, the second workbench, that just opens up for more crafting options that you can do. But for now, I should go mining, but I might save that for another episode. Because I forgot to start my stopwatch, so I don't know how far I'm into this episode. Real smart there, Casket. Make some more torches. Now, the pickaxe and the axe are not very good when it comes to weapons. Maybe in a pinch, but otherwise, really, no. Not very good. How many was it for this? 32. Okay. Well, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and make that. But I still have a lumber on me. Why am I doing that? Okay, let's get lumber made up. Shelter. I need to make sticks now. There we go. Now we should have enough. You use your arrow keys to turn the items however you want them to be turned. They go to sleep. Good morning. All right. See, even he's sleeping. They actually sleep. It looks like the pig up there. Yep, he's sleeping too. They do eventually go to sleep. Rabbit sleeping. So that's kind of cool. I like that. I like that. So let's see if I can find a quick cave. But first, let's take a look at where I'm at. 9:91 and 10:38. See if I can remember that. Let's see, where's the sun? Sun's coming up over there. Oh, there we go. All right. Straight down cave. Am I seeing anything good here? See, there's nothing that's jumping out saying, hey, come, you know, come take, you know, mind me, take care of this rock. There we go, and get some tomatoes. Okay. So let's see what else we're gonna find over here. Another bear, that's what I'm gonna find. What's this? Tungsten. I don't know what that can be used for off the top of my head, but I'm gonna mine it up anyway. Main thing I'm looking for right now is iron ore, but I also need stone, so I'll take the stone with this. I know at some point I will be needing tungsten, so why not go ahead and use it anyway, right? And the one other item about this is that there are no shovels. So if you need to level the grass, level the dirt area, because you're building something, you have to use your pickaxe. And the funny thing is, on some occasions, it still sounds like you're... Yeah, that's grass. I have a headstone in it too. But, you know, that still comes up sounding like I'm hitting into stone. This little vein goes down pretty far. And also, to my knowledge, I do not believe there is any durability with these axes and the pickaxe or the fire axe, the lumber axe, so you don't have to worry about them breaking on you. Although there is the option to building more and making more, I would assume that's because, you know, you could die and you could lose your items. And so if you can't, you know, if you end up losing it for whatever the reason, you can't make another one, you know, you're kind of SOL then, aren't you? Nice big vein there, so now I gotta dig my way out. You do not have to worry about grabbing what you break here as far as the stone or the dirt. It is going to... Oh, hello, you got closer. It automatically goes into your inventory. So where are we at now? Well, we moved quite a bit. So we were at 1080 or something like that, so... I can almost guarantee you I'm going to lose my spot. So, let this be a lesson to you guys that it actually might be better if you set up either A, next to a mining location, or B, mine from your own building, you know, where you're at. so now we're getting further away that way, so I know I need to go to my left. Oh, there's iron ore all the way down there. So I'm gonna start from right here. Where's that copper? It actually looks like copper. Oh, maybe not. It does look like iron ore. You can't really make normal stairs as you would in Minecraft, but you can get pretty close to that. Nice little wall glitch there, huh? Also, with the forge, and I'll go over it again after I make it, you do not need to stock it with coal or anything. It does seem that it will burn on its own once you put your ores in there. Yep, iron ore. Good, 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 good. Stone, I'm gonna move you down there, keep you separate. And this looks like it's a decent amount of it as well. Now, when you take damage as well, and I honestly couldn't say if there are any healing items in the game. I have not been hurt enough to the point where I needed those. Right there. You know what? What am I doing? Take you out. And one of those. There we go. The only downside with this is it does turn the walls a different shade. So you really have to be paying attention so you don't end up missing something if you go out and make your own mine shaft. There we go. We also made it to the bottom of the pit here. Now I wonder. I know if you use the dirt, you can put the dirt back down, but I don't think you can do that with the stone. Oh yeah, you can. How about that? What? Nope. Wait. What are you doing? The hell? Now, hold on, how much iron? I got 35. Nope, still 35. So it was lying to me. Come on, get up there. Okay. Oh, we got another one over here. What do we got? Anything? Anything good? Are the mining gods going to be nice to me? No, they are not. I know they have other items like silver in the game here, and apparently I've picked it up before. But I didn't really notice anything different about them. About the ore itself. I know there are textures to the ores, just like there is in Minecraft. But, I didn't, you know, it's one of those lighter colors, so it is difficult to notice and easy to pass up. I wonder what happens when you cut down these dead trees. Probably nothing. No saplings. Oh, did I get lucky? Because that looks like that was where I originally set up shop. Yep. That is some luck right there. So on that little stroke of good luck, I'm going to go ahead and end the episode here. And probably pick up where I left off here for episode 2. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. You stick along to see what else can come out, develop with this game as I continue to go along with it. So until then, guys, play safe.